Here's our blown up model. The top part right here is the cortex. So you could see the cortex right here, the renal medulla down here, and then the renal papilla is right here. Looking up top, the biggest thing that we're gonna look at here is our arteries and veins again. So coming up through here is our arcuate artery, red, and our arcuate veins. Down through the side, this is the interlobar artery and the interlobar vein. So those arteries and veins connect up here to the arcuate arteries. The arcuate arteries then stem off into the interlobular artery. The arcuate veins stem off into the interlobular vein. Those interlobular arteries will go into the afferent arteriole, which will then go into the glomerulus. From the glomerulus, you'll have the efferent arteriole coming out. So we'll kind of show you from this way, afferent going in, efferent coming out. The efferent arteriole will go into the peritubular capillaries and once again into the interlobular vein, into the arcuate vein, into the interlobar vein. Okay, so coming back up. So all these P's here are your Bowman's capsule or glomerular capsule. This one's opened up, so you can see the afferent arteriole coming in, and then the shoestring structure is your glomerulus, and that is this structure here, which we'll get to in a second. So then the first tube coming out, this tube is the proximal convoluted tubule. It will meet with the descending limb, then we go up to the ascending limb. Together, this is the nephron loop or the loop of Henle. That ascending limb connects to the distal convoluted tubule, which will dump all into the collecting tubule.